Hey everybody, Steven here, playing Subnautica Below Zero, and today covering an update that the devs have done to Below Zero in the experimental branch, and they've added a Seatruck docking station. So I did a video a couple weeks ago talking about the fact that they were going to be launching Subnautica 2.0, where they were going to be taking the base pieces from Below Zero and then bringing them over to Subnautica. I'm going to be doing a video on that here pretty soon, but they're also going to be updating some things with Below Zero. So this is the experimental build here. You can opt into this on Steam by going to the properties of the game. It says betas and you essentially just opt in, and then it just updates the game. And then you have access to this stuff. So we have our Seatruck and then a bunch of different modules here. I'm gonna get this lined out here in a second, but let's actually look at the docking station here. So right there, Seatruck dock. It takes a titanium ingot, advanced wiring kit, and then we have the four glass. So let's put this right here. Ta-da! It looks like a submarine. So as you can see, you'll actually bring the Seatruck in this way and then it will dock it. You see the door on the floor there. It will actually come up and then the Seatruck is in here and it's sealed off. And then the modules go back this way. You can also, in terms of where would you add kind of a hallway or whatever you're going to add to the back of this, is if it'll let me do it. There we go. Come on. Right there. There you go. Let's just hop in here real quick. Ta-da, there's nothing docked. So if we open the door, we're in water. If we dock this, this door will come up. If you don't have anything, the door will be shut just because you don't have any modules with it, right? So let's go ahead and grab, let me dock these together really quick. Let's grab the Seatruck and then let's look at the animations with this actually docking. There you go. And also, it's not doing together. Come on. All right, so we have three of these. So let's go ahead and pull this guy in there. It is a tight fit, I will tell you that. So you gotta get it pretty spot on, otherwise you're kind of like jerking the Seatruck around trying to get it to fit. So get this somewhat lined up. Ooh, that's a lot of bloom. And just like that, there we go. It's a tight fit. Come on, don't do this to me. I think I'm too high. What is going on? Third time's a charm. There we go. That was too low. There it is. The water drains. We hear that just like we did with the Seamoth dock, right? Got some stuff still floating around here. But then as you can see, now you can walk through your Seatruck still, right? And if you hop out this, you'll just go into the water. Now, this in-between point here, we got some video on it, right? Showing the camera. And then we get to change the color here. So let's go blue, the stripe, let's go red interior, let's go pink, name, white. Ta-da! Guess we can't use the upgrade console just yet. Yeah, view upgrade console doesn't do anything just yet. All right, we'll hop back in. Yeah, let's hop back in. Let's go get the other modules and then I'll pull this thing out. So drains water, literally rotates this back, attaches it for you, and then just backs you out. And that's it, back out, and then you're done. Obviously, you're going to need clearance with this. So let's go right here. I'll grab all these, get it lined out, and then we will actually pull this back and park it inside there and see how it looks. And we'll look at the color a little bit more. The thing I have noticed with the color, so that almost looks like purple, right? So the water is going to affect the look of the color. You get further away and then it's blue and then it like kind of looks like purple. So it does change this a little bit. And then you get up close, depending on the angle, depending on the time of day, all those things actually affect the look of the color. You can't change the colors independently either. So I can't change like one dock to be one color and then another one a different color, or portions of the interior different. You can't do any of that. I think that'd be cool. But if you notice, the second I dock this, right, it actually just syncs the color. So we'll actually dock this, watch my handlebar right here, and blue, done. So I do like that, because now you don't have to go back to the Seatruck dock in order to actually change the color of the modules here or to sync all of that up. But yeah, you can see the shade of color here changing. The interior seems to stay pretty consistent when it comes to this, but the outside, yeah, it does change color with it. And like I said, it does change and it is affected by the time of day as well. That middle one looks pretty white. So hopefully those are things that they can actually pan out. Or I don't know if that's also in by design, because water would actually affect that also, that which may be the case. All right. So we got, what, five of these things on there now? All right. This one's going to be harder to do. It's like steering a big bus. Oh, man. Because the speed is affected by how many of these things you have on here. All right. Oh, this looks like it's going to be rough. All right, let's go down. Down, 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 down. Please don't get caught. Did I do better with more modules on here? No, not really. Oh, come on. Get it. No, let's go. You got it. Muscle through. Muscle through. There it is. All right. And voila. There it is. Look it. So let's exit on this thing. And now you can see, yeah, the tail end. I mean, it'll come out on this. So now it's basically going into nighttime here. You can see that that has affected the color a little bit. I think the docking station looks really cool, though. The only thing that I could see where maybe a different design choice would be having this so it's just one continuous tube. So it would, like, pass through and then, like, on this end or something like that, where you have the open area where you can do the adjustments to the color and you can actually extend this off your base. It would just go right here. So when you leave, you just go straight, go through it. And then this is where, like I said, it connects to your base and you can make those adjustments to the color and everything. So that is it. Still cool to see that they're doing updates like this, quality of life stuff for the game, even after release now, because the game has been out a little over a year now. But let me know what you guys actually think about this in the comment section with this. And like I said, if you want to actually look at this yourself, just opt into the experimental branch with this, and then you will have access to this as well. So that's going to be it for this one. I will have a video out soon showcasing the base pieces coming from Below Zero over to Subnautica for their 2.0 release. Still no date on that yet, but I've heard that they actually have those bases, the base pieces in the experimental branch with that game as well. Still working on trying to actually get that looked at so I can actually cycle through and just see what's in, what's not in. So that's going to be it for this one, everybody. Like I said, let me know what you guys actually think about this in the comment section. If you like the video, hit the like button for me. If you want to continue to follow along with all my content, hit the subscribe button for me. And as always, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.